Why?
So although this is going to be mainly a repair video, I want to introduce a new series I'll be doing called Will It Fail, where we test equipment to its breaking point. There'll be a small segment of Will It Fail in this video. All right, so if you guys watched my last video about me purchasing this inverter on eBay and it arriving DOA, not quite DOA, but it's reading the voltage, but there's no AC output. What that means, typically, on these inverters, there are 8 fuses inside, and they're in pairs of two, 240 amp fuses in parallel. And in order for this display to not read any output, one pair of those fuses have to be broken. If one fuse is broken, the inverter will still operate to about 160 amps. Very likely that there are two fuses blown in this inverter. All right, so before we take this inverter apart, I want to illustrate the proper way to discharge the inverter. You never want to just go in here blind. The capacitors can hold charge for weeks, months on end, and it can be very dangerous inside. So, the battery is on, and our inverter is on. So you notice when I turn off the inverter, it'll make a sound. It's a short sound. Now let's compare that sound against the sound when the battery is turned off while the inverter is on. So inverter on and battery off. So we're basically going to disconnect the battery. It's the same thing if I just remove the cables from the battery. So I'm able to turn my battery off. See the voltage dropping? And this LED. Now there's not even enough power to keep this LED lit. Very tiny amount of power still left in these capacitors, so it's relatively safe at this point. But notice the difference in the length of the tone when it was actually discharging. So when the battery's on, and you just turn off the inverter after it's been charged, that is not a discharge. Don't get those confused. Don't think, oh, well, I turned it off, made the sound, and it's discharged. It's all good. You want to disconnect the battery. If you can't actually turn off your battery, like a lot of batteries you buy on Amazon, whatnot, there's no display. You have to actually disconnect the cable from the battery. So I'll do that. Just to illustrate what you would have to do, physically disconnect, and you should always physically disconnect the battery from your inverter. And now when we turn it on, it's going to discharge. You can see our battery is still on, but it's disconnected from the inverter. This is a 3000 watt inverter by Reputable Energy. They make the sound when you discharge them. So make sure you check with your manual to find out how to properly discharge your inverter. I hope I have it zoomed in enough to where you can at least see the fuses down here. These orange fuses, they're going to look like this. And there's a total of 8 fuses, 2, 4, 6, 8. And you can see that there's 4 black wires. So each wire is 40 amp wire, 40, 80, 120, 160. Each pair of fuses are actually on a single circuit. So if only one fuse is blown and you go to do your test, you may not know that the other fuse is blown because the inverter can actually operate, as I was saying before, with just one of these fuses in. But there was no AC output. We're looking for 2 of these to be blown. But you may have to test individually all of them, actually pull them out of their sockets and test them to see if one of them are actually blown because of the way these are connected in parallel. Okay, so this is a good fuse here, and if you probe either the top pins up here, or you can, if you take the fuse out, you can actually probe the actual connectors. But if you just look at the fuse, and you can see it'll be black, or this thing will completely be disconnected in here, just completely blown out. But to do the test, easiest to do is with you just holding your hands, click it, and just touch it like that. If you get a tone, that means the fuse is good because the circuit's able to connect. So we're going to go through these and we're going to look for a double failure. So we're going to have two fuses that are essentially disconnected or blown. So we're looking for a no tone. That's good. That's good. 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 Ah, see that? No sound right there. No sound. This could be bad. And this one? This is the one in parallel. These are both likely bad. We're going to take these out. And we're just going to grab the fuse on either end and wiggle it out. That's the easiest way for it to come out. Gently wiggle it out. So we'll just do a visual inspection. And there should be a little bridge in there, and it's completely just, oops, sorry. Yeah, that thing is completely just goner. I mean, it blew out in fashion too. All right, this one. Same thing, but it's just got a little black in it. Remember, we're looking for no tone. And we have no tone. We're going to replace these two fuses, but I want to show you, I want to illustrate how I was saying earlier, the inverter can actually run since these two plugs, each pair, are wired in parallel. They're creating an 80 amp circuit. You probably wouldn't have a case where one fuse is blown only, because if you're running that high of amps and one fuse goes, the other one's going to go immediately after it. You know, I just want to show you that the inverter can run up to about a point, and then it'll actually blow that fuse because it's supposed to be an 80 amp circuit with two fuses versus just a 40 amp circuit with one fuse. All right, so I'm going to blow this completely good fuse just for science sake. We're going to put it in one of the slots, and we're going to leave the other slot blank. And I'm going to try to position the camera so that we can actually hear it when it pops. Do a quick test. All right. I have the camera positioned right over the fuse. So there's the one we just put in. And there's the empty slot right next to it. And the battery's on. And we're going to monitor on the BMS as we overload this circuit so the fuse blows. So now that we have one fuse in, we should have an AC output over here now. When we turn on the inverter, let's see if that lights up. There it is. We've got the status and now it's going up 120, 122 volts. So I'm gonna fire up the first space heater. That'll get us to about 130 amps or so, which is not enough to blow the fuse. And then I'll fire up a second one as we watch the BMS and listen for that fuse. We're trying to make it pop. Okay, we're pulling 60 amps. Okay, we're pulling 85 amps. I'm gonna put this on high. Now pulling 148 amps. I'm gonna back off over here. 150 amps. I'm surprised it hasn't blown. It's still, I think it's gonna be right around 160 where we're gonna see it fail. Because each circuit is, I think, 80 amps, right? So that makes sense. All right, we're gonna fire up a second heater and listen closely. There she goes. It took 200 amps. It took about 215 amps for about 3 seconds. So I was surprised. And the fans never even came on this thing. So we can see the same thing as before when we started this repair, if you want to call it. The inverter's on and it's reading 13.2 volts, but the AC output is gone. So we've lost our AC output. That's because we blew that fuse. So let's change these fuses out for good. All right, so we're just gonna pull this fuse out. You can see what happened to that one. Completely destroyed. So let's put two good fuses in here and we'll call it good. 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 All right, so this inverter is good to go. We're gonna put the cover back on and call it good. Why? That is why you pre-charge. Now we'll talk about pre-charge in another video. I thought the battery was off. Pull up our BMS. Let's turn on the space heater. I'm pulling 36 amps, 46 amps, 56. So we're pulling, we stopped at 80. So we're pulling a constant 80. It's putting out some good heat right there. Yeah, looks like this inverter is good to go. That is awesome. Now we got a perfectly good test unit that I didn't pay a whole lot for, and it works. So, yeah, what else could you ask for? 150 amps of heat. And I just wanted to show you how I was able to get this inverter working by changing the fuse. So always be careful, use common sense, and do it at your own risk. And thanks for watching.